Alonzo Today Newsroom. This is Memos from the National Affairs Desk. Presented by Gonzo Today. www.gonzotoday.com. The weird have just turned pro.
Hello, and reporting for Gonzo Today's Memos from the National Affairs Desk, I am Dr. Jeffurious Higgason. A bill that would decriminalize possession of a limited amount of marijuana is now in the hands of Illinois Governor Bruce Rauner. The state Senate approved a bill 3719 on Thursday to remove criminal penalties for possession of up to 15 grams of marijuana. The measure, which was approved by the House of Representatives in April, will now be sent to Rauner. While Rauner this year issued the first licenses for medical marijuana distributors, the fate of the decriminalization bill is uncertain. House Bill 218, introduced in the Senate by Senator Michael Nolan and in the House by Representative Kelly Cassidy, makes possession of up to 15 grams of marijuana a civil law violation punishable by a $125 fine. Individuals will no longer face jail time, and the civil offense will be automatically expunged in order to prevent a permanent criminal record. First-time possession between 30 and 100 grams would be misdemeanors. Currently, possession of 10 grams or more is a felony. Representative Cassidy said in a statement that serious criminal penalties should be reserved for individuals who commit serious crimes. Chicago has already loosened the penalty for possessing small amounts of marijuana, making it subject to a fine rather than a criminal charge. Under current Illinois law, possession of up to 2.5 grams of marijuana is a Class C misdemeanor, punishable by up to 30 days in jail and or a fine of $1,500. Possession of 2.5 to 10 grams is a Class B misdemeanor, punishable by up to 6 months in jail and or a fine of up to $1,500. And possession of 10 to 30 grams is a Class 4 felony, punishable by up to 1 year in jail and or a $1,500 fine. Chris Lindsay, a legislative analyst for the Marijuana Policy Project, said Thursday, "We hope Governor Rauner will sign this important and broadly supported legislation. It's time to stop destroying people's lives over possession of a substance that is undeniably less harmful than alcohol." Elsewhere in the news, a Pennsylvania teen's family said her Sweet 16 party was spoiled and soiled when apparent airplane bathroom waste fell on the birthday girl and her guest. Joe Cambry of Levittown said there were about 40 people at the party on Sunday for his stepdaughter Jacinda, and the apparent human waste fell from the sky while some of the guests were in the pool and others were playing horseshoes. Cambry told WTXF-TV, "It came out of nowhere from the sky. Here comes a bunch of feces and it's landing on everybody." Cambry said the canopy here erected in the yard was the epicenter of the fecal impact. He also said that all the feces landed on the baby seat that was sitting there. Cambry's sister Christy said that they had just gotten done with cake, and thank God they took the cake back in, because within 2 minutes something fell from the sky. It was brown, it was icky, it was everywhere, and it got on everything. Christy used a smartphone app to discover there were 3 airplanes in the sky near the party at the time of the incident. The Federal Aviation Administration said the incident is being investigated. Officials said regulations require planes to dispose of their waste at an airport, not while flying over a residential area. Talk about a shitty birthday party, right?
That's news.
We got some more news coming up, but right now here's Pee Wee Herman with a word about crack cocaine addiction.
This is crack. Rock cocaine. It isn't glamorous or cool or kid stuff. It's the most addictive kind of cocaine, and it can kill you. What's really bad is nobody knows how much it takes. So every time you use it, you risk dying. It isn't worth it. Look, everybody wants to be cool. But doing it with crack isn't just wrong. It could be dead wrong.
Stress, or maybe is your sinus drainage? Do you
have tied blood. Very, very, or maybe you're a little overweight. You better make some correction in all this infection. Just send in $1.98. Get rid of that running nose, that nagging cough, that sneeze, that chew, that wheeze, and other injuries. Take the wonder drug that cures all your ills. Take Jeremiah Peabody's polyunsaturated, quick dissolving, fast acting, pleasant tasting green and purple pills. Oh yeah. Well, it won't upset your stomach. It's good for arthritis. It soothes all your aches and pains. Get rid of those hammers in your head. Don't be a hypochondriac. Start feeling better again. Clear up that fungus among us. It's good for every ailment, including water on the knee. And it's guaranteed to be just what you need for quick, fast, speedy relief. Get rid of that running nose, that nagging cough, that sneeze, that chew, that wheeze, and other injuries. Take the wonder drug that cures all your ills. Take Jeremiah Peabody's polyunsaturated, quick dissolving, fast acting, pleasant tasting green and purple pills. Oh yeah, little green and purple pills.
Earlier this week, Google apologized after users reported typing a racial slur into Google Maps causes the website to zoom into the White House in Washington, D.C. Users of the map program said that searching for the word, the, quote, N-word, along with the word, quote, house, caused Google Map to bring up a zoomed-in map of 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue, the White House. And searches conducted from multiple geographical locations had the same result. I kind of wonder what these people are doing anyway, just throwing in combinations of words to see where Google Maps would go. I bet a lot of us would be surprised, to tell you the truth. Some users reporting getting the same result using the alternate spelling, replacing the ER at the end of the racial slur with an A. A Google representative told the Washington Post some inappropriate results are surfacing in Google Maps that should not be, and we apologize for any offense this may have caused. Our teams are working to fix this issue quickly. Bomani Bookhalter, who posted it, it's his real name, Bomani Bookhalter, who posted a screenshot of his search results to Twitter, said some friends in other locations reported the same came back with different results. Bookhalter told the Huffington Post it's location-based, so for some of the students that are not currently in D.C., the search result was different. However, if you're not in D.C., racial slur house, Washington, D.C., shows the same results. Google Maps allows users to take alterations with its map-making software. However, the feature was recently suspended following acts of vandalism following a map of Pakistan altered to show an image of the Android logo urinating on an Apple logo. How clever. How clever. The art supply company Crayola is warning against following the advice of beauty bloggers who have posted tutorials for using colored pencils as eyeliner. YouTube videos from beauty bloggers, including RCL Beauty 101, have gone viral this month, with tutorials showing how to soak Crayola colored pencils in warm water for a few minutes to soften them up to use them as eyeliner pencils. RCL Beauty 101 says in her videos, companies literally make it so little kids can eat it and still be fine. Crayola responded to the trend on its website, saying the non-toxic labels on the pencils does not mean that they are tested safe to be used as cosmetic. As a matter of fact, the company said on its website, as the manufacturer of children's products, safety is our top priority at Crayola. Although our products are non-toxic, we do not recommend using them to make lipstick, eyeliner, or other makeup and strongly discourage their use in this manner. They are not designed, tested, or approved for this purpose. So just go ahead and go back to eating the paste. We know that stuff's all natural. Finally, I'd like to take this opportunity to send out condolences and warm thoughts to Gonzo Today's managing editor, David Pratt, and his family. David's sister, Karen, passed away earlier this week after fighting a long battle with cancer. David told me that Karen was a colossal fan of the band Cracker. So in remembrance of Karen, we're going to leave you now with a song by Cracker. Here is Cracker with another song about the rain.
Wind of fate is bright or slew. Light of mercy hurts my eyes. Is it worth things you lose? Board the train and watch the sky. I sing myself to sleep at night. I sing myself to sleep. Another song about the rain coming down and burst through me. The time went to another place we were smart before the flood and time was through. I sing myself to sleep at night. I sing myself to sleep. Wow.
The news you have just heard was a digest of Press Association dispatches. Further details will be found in your newspapers.